Hello everyone, and welcome back to Alice Madness Returns. In the previous episode, we made our way through the Vale of Doom very, very poorly, using a distinct lack of skill, and we have now arrived in Chapter 3? Yeah, 3, which is the Mysterious East section. Now, hello, cat?
The author obliterated the distinction between poetry and pessimism.
Whatever you say. Oh, God. Got any leeches for this? Okay, I don't remember very much about this at all, this area, so I'm going to miss even more things than normal. Ooh, a carp. In the course of this area. I do remember this one being quite nasty as well, so I'm not going to dwindle too long and we'll just sort of get through this. I'm not going to be quite as anal with collecting teeth and that kind of thing. We're doing alright for now, so we'll just kick on and see how we do. Alrighty. Whoa, okay. An air vent? Not an air vent. An air jet? Plume? Jet plume? J-E-T, J-E-T. You are so good. You are so good for me. Ooh, crap. A little bit too eager there. Don't want to rush too hard. There's a horrible new class of enemy introduced in this area, which I remember without fondness, shall we say. Apparently there is a keyhole here. Hello. And these are, I guess these are mahjong tiles that we're jumping on, probably. There's a lot of sort of Japanese kind of influence here, which was quite fashionable in the late Victorian times, in fact. That's why the most famous Gilbert and Sullivan play, The Mikado, was set in Japan.
Dodgson is a pathetic sailor and an even worse captain. We'd have run aground on the ISIS if I hadn't taken an oar.
Intriguing. And of course the word ISIS now has extremely negative connotations around it. So much so, in fact, that in the popular British period drama Downton Abbey, the main character, played by Hugh Bonneville, I think it was that character, originally had a dog called Isis, right? And the dog was named after the Egyptian goddess, ancient Egyptian goddess Isis. And then when the Islamic State was kind of established as a major terrorist organization, they unceremoniously killed off that dog in Downton Abbey, like off camera, which I thought was pandering to... Oh, is that a snout? Is it? Is that what I'm looking at? Or am I just shooting nothing here? Okay, maybe not. Yeah, I thought that was like, you know, letting them win in a way. Kind of... Sorry, I don't want to get too political in this video. It's not my intention to cause any kind of discourse of that kind in gaming videos on YouTube, but I did think that was quite tragic how they decided to kill off hang on a minute. We're supposed to be climbing upwards. Okay. Well, whatevs. These are shrines, very much like the shrines that you that replace bonfires, Dark Souls bonfires in Neo. They are the things that you pray at in Neo. They are like very common on trails. They're sort of like markers on trails in rural Japan and things like that. And they're like little shrines that you can pray at. That honeycomb thing looks like we need to use the teapot to blow it open. You maniacs! You blow it up! Ooh, a gold tooth. I will take that. What's over here? Anything interesting? Well, there's some stuff here. I can't work out whether I'm backtracking or not. Is this the first lever I pulled, or is this a new one? No, it's the first one. Or appears to be. But there is a bottle here, so that's something. Okay, fine. Are we on 462? What can we actually get? What do we want to be upgrading? Probably the pepper grinder and hobby horse most of all. So, we'll, yeah, okay. So we'll go upgrade the pepper grinder next when we get up to 575 teeth. In the meantime, we need to find the way that we're actually supposed to be going here. And probably to where that high ledge was with the thing we can blow open, which was back this way, was it not? I'm really not paying attention to the direction in which I'm supposed to be going here. It sort of caught me off guard that how uncharacteristically non-linear this is. Okay, there it is. So this came out of the... Oh, right, yeah, it's a mushroom. Terrific. Hopefully this isn't a red herring. And we can, if I remember how to do it... There we go. Bomb that. Oh, it was just a memory.
Whoever said true art serves neither ornament nor use is ignorant of the aesthetic of the East.
Yep, fine. Whatever you say, mate. So, we've come from there. We've sort of done a complete loop back to the beginning. I'm not getting exactly where we are supposed to be going right now. There's another memory or bottle out on that little island. I'm not bothered about getting that. I'm going to go back and explore these stairs again, because this seems like we need to be heading up this tall mountain in the background, so that's something. But there are these ninja insects in this level which are so super annoying. I absolutely bloody hate them. Okay, let's continue up this trail. And we'll sort of go... Who's that? Caterpillar? Yeah. Oh, God. Well, good. I call bullshit on that, you know. I didn't walk off the edge as far as I could tell. You could probably tell that better than me by watching this video. I probably did, knowing me. But still. There are very slight... Like I say, what I described in the... Probably the first episode of this series as technical inconsistencies... just things, it just, this game could have done with another like 3 or 4 months of polish, but considering it's low budget and it really does achieve a great deal. Right, we came up here, right? Can we get up there? Ah, now this looks more promising. Here we go, yeah, and this is where we're going to be introduced to this hellish new enemy. And I have no recollection of how we actually deal with these guys. So we're just going to have to hope for the best. Probably fail miserably. Boink. And another memory.
What Nurse Witless said was, the fire whooshed in, lit her up like the guy on Cracker Night. No one knows how she survived, except Alice, and she's stum, remember?
She's stum. Mum's the word. Really cool art direction in this level. I love all the lanterns and the sort of kind of Japanese characters going by on the skybox and stuff. It just looks really nice. And like I say, the art direction in this game never fails to impress me, even though it is made on a low budget and all that stuff. Here we go. Oh, these guys. Samurai Wasp. I mean, that's a pretty sensible title for these guys, actually. Oh, God, I forgot the button for lock on. Oh, it's L2. Okay. This is not a good start. Okay, we can break their guard and stun them with the hobby horse. Trying to remember the buttons. It's been a little while since I played. Yeah, and to remember the dodge button is very important. He's lost his mask. Smash him with the horse thing. There we go. Finish him. Right, one down. They don't break their guard for very long. Alright, that was two. Wasn't there three? Fair enough. Yep, we'll keep moving then. Well on the way to getting the next upgrade with the teeth as well, so I'm just going to carry on sort of leisurely collecting them. Boink. Pull the chain. Take a sip of my beverage. Delicious. Okay, an air vent. Not an air vent, why do I keep saying that? Sorry, I'm very tired. I had a very long day at work today. God. Shit. Wow, the tracking on that move. Attack quickly. Right, okay, so they don't have very much HP, in fact. It's just getting the window. Yeah. Alright, not bad. That was bad, though. Kill him quickly, and then dodge the other one. Fine, nice. Yeah, this is like Neo. This is like Alice in Wonderland Neo. So the combat is surprisingly, like, precise and satisfying and technical at when it's sped up to that sort of speed. You have to play as aggressively and quickly as they play in order to sort of survive their attacks, which is really cool. Yeah, we're just going to carry on this way. Oh, there's a keyhole. Might as well get it, I suppose. Why not? It's probably a memory.
Certain smells are one-off. You'd never mistake burning human flesh for roasting a lamb chop.
Aha. Was that the creepy woman from the start of the game? The horrible Scottish hag who turned into a Jabberwocky? I can't remember. This way. This away. Okay, the linearity is coming back now. This is where I'm comfortable. Gonna create another jet stream for me. Jet stream lover. No platform. That'll do just as well. So. Oh, that was badly timed. Whew. Oh, there was a jet stream. J-E-T, J-E-T, you are so good for me. One of my favourite bands.
She who saves a single soul saves the universe. Remember?
Not really. Wow, this is a pretty looking place. I imagine it's going to be full of death wasps. Yes, indeed. Die quickly. Oh, that was very poor. So when they telegraph, they then do basically a move with unlimited tracking, which you sort of have to dodge like that. You don't seem to be able to kind of tank it or anything, so... Oh, God! Right. Ooh, a daimyo wasp. Okay, now what I do not remember how to kill you. How do I break your guard and make you stay still? Okay. Much the same way. Oh yes, you have to take his armor off piece by piece. A situation where having the fully upgraded Vorpal Blade is extremely beneficial. As you can see, they don't really have very much HP. It's in mobs when they become more of a problem. And there are these weird little paper fuckers who are like peaceful to you. Grasshoppers,
she,
that's it.
Chosen one?
Our savior?
Our benefactor!
Our benefactor!
Don't think I don't see you there, destructible wall. What does this do? Takes me
we'll
to a memory.
Keep just the one lamp, Alice, as a nightlight, but it stays in the upstairs hall and only
speak
till
the
you
elder.
Turn 12.
Yes, you really must. He knows things. He even thinks things.
Mm-hmm. I see a violet over here, which implies something secret, but also will just restore my HP. Ooh, an invisible snout. Well, when in Rome, as they say. Just about there. Well, it was just a bottle. I mean, better than nothing, I suppose. I really like this palm forest area. Looks great. Mm-hmm. Oh, God, it's one of these. Well, it looks like all the pieces might be
your
there.
Your victories in combat and conundrums suggest your fitness to confront the challenges ahead. Mental strength will confirm your worthiness or declare your defeat.
Fair play. So, oh, we do have to collect the other pieces. Boink. One through here, please. Okay, I can see it. Oh, God. I didn't see you. I'll give you that one, matey. You actually took me by surprise. Ow. Please die. I can't see you. Oh, you went in the water. Fair enough. Let us... Okay, clockwork bomb this way. What, in fact, are we supposed to be doing here? Aha! Pop that little guy down. And collect the shit out of that brick. The butterflies, when she does the dodge and does the butterflies, it reminds me of the intro to Elder Scrolls 4 Shivering Isles. And I'm sure most of you will know what I'm talking about there, but the Shivering Isles expansion for Oblivion begins with a load of butterflies, and it was mind-blowing. The graphics on that when I first saw it blew me away. Still looks very good today, especially by the standards of Oblivion. Again, when that Oblivion came out, I genuinely thought that it looked, the landscape looked real. And now it really needs a lot of mods to make me that impressed these days. Boom. Is that all of them now? Yes. It's a dragon. Let's swap. I'm assuming that the head is going to be at the top right, probably. Or is it? I mean, because it's two colours. So, no, yeah, okay, it's two colour dragons. So that means the head needs to be lowered down, right? Oh, we've got limited moves. Oh, I'm going to fail this, aren't I? So it needs to be like this. There we go.
You can save us. I'll open the path.
Thank you for opening the path. I will try my best to save you. I already went in there. What's through here? A load of Jetstream lovers and a keyhole. Alrighty.
She is certainly ill. She imagines odd things, and she has a hero complex, an inherent desire to help others, being unable to help herself, and a compulsion to make the world right. She's trying to unlock the true meaning of her life, and she doesn't know who has the key.
Hmm. Very intriguing. That doctor is one of the most important characters in the game, so it's worth paying attention to the things that he says. If you are sort of interested in the story and lore of this game series, it is well worth going on the hunt for all of the hidden sort of collectibles and bits and bobs. It is sort of in a Dark Souls way, you don't really get the full picture unless you do that, but it's mostly background lore that you get from it. I mean, it's not like the two Alice games have an especially complicated plot, far from it.
The wicked wasps lay siege upon us and control the peaks to east and west. You must defeat them to reach Caterpillar's retreat.
I suppose I must go to the mountaintop, as it won't come to me.
We have faith that Caterpillar, the strange and wondrous, helps those in need. One day we'll have proof. Purity of heart is to will one thing, to approach his sacred eyrie. You must confront the savage daimyos. You prevent our access to his power. I'll open the entrance to the sacred caves where your journey begins.
Thank you very much. That sounds ominous. Oh yes, I remember now. If you remember back in the Tundrafall area, just before the Deluded Depths, we had that sort of side mission bit where there was like a 2D sort of R-type style shooter. And this is another bit like this. Another sort of random little mini-game almost. Alice can move, jump, shrink, and use her float as normal. Move carefully to avoid the hazards.
Regard this depiction of domestic harmony and order. The fruitful landscape encouraged industry, tolerance, and cooperation. Loving families flourished, happy children, dear friends, grateful for their well-being, lived for generations, secure, active, and free. But a sudden onslaught of alien attacks broke their fragile bodies and nearly crushed their generous spirits.
Intriguing. Done in a beautiful block print kind of aesthetic style. Reminiscent of sort of papercraft, like origami, and also, like of course, those Japanese block prints and watercolours. Ow. Supposed to shrink there. I remember this being forgiving with checkpoints and not especially difficult, but we'll see how difficult it in fact is. I think there's more than one of these as well, if memory serves, but I don't really recall. It's just nice that they put these things in as well. Like, to be honest, in all honesty, I would have preferred that the time spent developing these mini-games was instead used to just further polish the main 3D platforming experience, because if they'd have done that, then it would have probably elevated the game just a little bit more in people's kind of, you know, people's kind of, what's the word, like opinion on it or whatever, it probably would have done a little bit better critically and got a little bit more noticed if it were just a little bit more polished. Collect the peach. But nonetheless, I am glad that they did put these bits in because they are really fun. And, you know, they're not like redundant and like a drag. When it stops the normal gameplay to give you something like this, it is always actually kind of enjoyable. So, well, it's no less enjoyable than the main game is. So you kind of... You know, I'm a little bit divided about my opinion on it because it's well done. It's really well done, and these sections are really well polished as well. But they're not. Oh, that was a bomb. I thought I was supposed to drop down there. They're not like essential to the experience. So I kind of think maybe they should have just really refined the main game instead of doing this, unless of course they kind of outsourced these sections to a different team or whatever they did. I'm not sure. I'll have that and I'll have that. Oh, we've got enough to upgrade, in fact. Okay, we can't do it now. To wait till we get back to the main game to do it. That was very badly timed. Whew, that was very close. Okay. Up here, I guess. I'm assuming that did something that I wanted to happen. Yeah, okay, that's the first... yeah, so I'm sure there are more than one of those sections. I remember there being more than one. Anyway. But we are, in fact, making progress.
Only the foolish believe suffering is just wages for being different.
Right, you are. These, like... sort of paper bridges I remember these. The obviously the flashing red characters burn you, so you just need to sort of run around and avoid those. Not too bad. Oh, I remember these. The wasp archers. God. Flying enemies. As you know if you watch my other videos, I hate flying enemies in games. I really, really hate them. I don't do well with flying enemies of any sort, really. Hello? Okay. Okay. Smash that stuff. Oh yes, now we can get the... Actually, this is a perfect time to upgrade the pepper grinder. Because we're going to be using it. Yes. Hey, it looks badass now. Yeah, pretty good. Oh, it was you. Okay. I thought there was just one guy who was miraculously managing to hit me. Alright, so that was actually pretty good timing. It was worth kind of doing that. There's a chain this way according to the violet graffiti. Here we go. Sip of the beverage. Ah, excellent. Sorry, I'm allowing myself to have a beer tonight. I had a really long day at work, and I love my job, but it was just a really stressful day, and I wasn't really... When I was sort of driving home from work today, I didn't even... really feel up to recording anything this evening, but I figured I owe it to you guys to get back on these series that have lain dormant for the last few weeks and get them all finished off so we can move on to Pastures Green, New Horizons, exciting new Let's Plays. And hopefully you're actually enjoying this one as well. hello, buddy? Any more? What's that? That little light move. Oh, it's just one of those glowworms. Is this explosive? No. The sort of glowing red logo on that barrel made me think it was going to explode when I attacked it. But should probably have done a ranged attack for safety's sake. Okay. Onwards through the cave of trials or whatever this is called. Hey, buddy. Ow. That's how you do it. Except that I got hit, of course, so that's probably not how you do it, in fact. I was just looking away from the screen there. I didn't actually see where that opened up, so we'll just have to kind of hope for the best. Still got very high physics turned up. After that experience in the Vale of Doom with the getting stuck in the violet through that excessive rubble particles glitch, I should really have turned that off, but never mind, eh? What's that? A crack of daylight, is it? Okay. Just to check that I do have to backtrack. I didn't see where that actually did open up, so I'm just making sure that I'm not going to backtrack needlessly. What was that? Something like glowing just there. A weird little passageway of some sort. Yeah, there. Weird. Okay, we'll backtrack. And presumably continue to ascend this evil mountain of doom. Ah, that was bad. Okay, I take full responsibility for the amateurish play there. Is that where we need to be going? Is that where I've opened up? Where have I respawned? Where is this? Is this where I came into the... Ah, yes, okay. I get you. Sorry. Obviously, it's going to be perfectly obvious to you guys, but you have to give it 3 or 4 seconds for everything that happens for my brain to catch up, because I'm a little bit slow. Samurai Ink Wasp. Is that like a samurai pizza cat? What is it? A piece of stone? Oh, yeah. It seems to be making the equivalent from this level of bolt flies, which stop you attacking and cling onto you and drain your HP. And this fucker right here needs to head the shit out. Please die, sir. No, don't hit me. I said die. God damn it. Right. Okay, so is it... Oh, I think it is just like a bolt fly nest. Like the stone thing. Yeah, it is. It's creating these. So we just need to not get swarmed by ink things and try and kill all of these in a vaguely efficient way. Oh, just die! Right. And now you. Is that all of them? Yes. I noticed some collectible or destructible jars with collectibles in just over the other side. We will just go and break those because they might contain health. They do. So we want that. And we will continue onwards and upwards. Ooh, creepy faces carved into the rock. Hey, didn't see you there, bud. You had a gold tooth and you dropped it down the bottomless pit. I do not appreciate that kind of thing. Let me tell you. Nice. Alright. I always forget to switch to the teapot when my pepper grinder overheats. Is that going to open for me? Whoa, Christ. You actually made me jump. Give you that one, mate. Give you that. And you die now. There is a mushroom. That well looks like it should be a secret entrance. Oh, yes. Well, this will probably be the answer to that little conundrum. Yeah, that's right. A laughing Buddha. Hang on a minute. Is this supposed to be Chinese or Japanese or both? Because Buddhism is largely a Chinese religion, is it not? I don't know. Woo, next area. Yes, of course, the inevitable slide as well. Ow. Christ. Hopefully we can get a little bit of a health drop from one of those jars. And just try and traverse the molten, ruinous tar without running over it, please. And of course, collect the teeth and jump, 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 jump. Okay. Crisis averted. Continue. Fine. Fine and dandy, all good. This bit looks very dangerous. Now, of course, everyone is going to see this and think of Super Mario 64. And you will be right to make that connection in your head. 3D platformer, sliding down a slide, collecting things, avoiding hazards, jumping over gaps. Of course, Super Mario 64 did it first. I'll land on the giant table. Whew. Yes, there are random pieces of furniture. Okay, so it looks like we may be nearly at the end of this area. Although, I remember there being considerably more than this. Pop the drawers out. Pop your little drawers out. What is that from? Oh, it's the Mighty Boosh. If you get that reference, then you're awesome. Mighty Boosh is awesome, and you are awesome for thinking the Mighty Boosh is awesome. Unless, of course, you don't think it's awesome, in which case you suck. Ah, shit. Alright. That went well. I even got his gold tooth. I see you there, bud. Oh, what? You can't actually... They have, like, iframe, like, power... They have power armor on their attacks. Once they've started telegraphing, they actually... will continue their attack even when you attack them in between and interrupt. Good to know, but still slightly annoying. What's this? Okay, I feel like we need to come back there in a minute. Once we have made more platforms appear, probably. This is starting to come back to me, this area. I do remember this particular bit of this area quite distinctly. Shitting hell. Oh, there's multiple. They are legion. Well, this is going badly. You need to die. Oh, it's you as well. You're a problem. Alright, we need to take out this thing. It's a matter of some urgency. I'm, like, getting absolutely smashed here. Oh, God. Use the thingy. Oh, it was you! Right, okay. Well, I wasn't expecting this. Give me all that health. Right. Okay, we survived. I know there's more. There's more. Of course there's more. Yeah. Right then. That was bad. What does this do? Where does it take me? To another switch. And the switch seems to lead to another switch. Or rather, a lever. Or lever. Let's go and do this first. Presumably we will need to do all of them, so let's just do it somewhat methodically. Okay, it's moved the wooden thing. Wooden pagoda thing. And now we'll carry on this way, I suppose. Oh, I just did that. Well, fair enough. Let's move on. And hopefully not have a horrible encounter like we just did. Or at least be able to handle a simple combat mob a little better than that. We got an autosave at least. Ah, Violet. Perfection itself. And we'll go in the keyhole in just a moment. I need to restore all my HP from this Violet. Lovely. Just going to have another sip of beer. Ah, lovely. Keep your hands off my hiney. I don't normally drink lager. Well, I do sometimes. I do when it's like really hot weather. But I'm drinking lager today. I'm drinking Heineken, in fact, which is quite mainstream. But it is very nice and very cold and very refreshing.
Radcliffe asked me in just the once. Odd duck. Very proud of his artifacts. Ming, I think he said. And partial to Tokugawa Japan. Doesn't seem the samurai type, but perhaps that's why.
Hmm. That's very interesting. And when I say very interesting, I mean not very interesting. Carrying swiftly on. While I was talking about those 2D minigames, in fact, I do feel like, now that I think about it in hindsight a little bit, having played one, they do break up the gameplay loop a little bit in quite a nice way, because the gameplay in this game in general is quite repetitive. It does have these platforming segments are only distinct from one another visually. Pretty much the same thing every time. And the game is fairly long for a game of this type. Certainly, I mean, for a linear one. Not like a Banjo-Kazooie Mario 64 style sort of open world one in a way.
The conflagration's point of origin was obvious. First, the library caught fire, and it spread disastrously when the gas line exploded.
Oh god, I just fell to my doom. Terrific. Yeah, a Mario 64 sort of Banjo-Kazooie type of one. Why am I back here? That's no good. A Mario 64 Banjo-Kazooie style semi-open world kind of, or open format, fucking hell, 3D platformer. You know, obviously you would get a lot of hours of playtime out of that, something like that, but a truly linear one with just a set kind of linear path through its worlds and its levels like this, you don't really expect them to last longer than maybe 5 to 8 hours. This one is maybe 8 hours or something, maybe a little bit more than that, but it feels a lot longer. In a good way, that is. I'm not sort of going, oh yeah, it's 8 hours, but it's just a total slog to get through, and it's like, it feels like it's really, like, you know, it takes ages to get through, and you're just waiting for it to end. It's not the case. It's a very fun game, and an underrated game. Ooh, okay, so there's a little house door there, which is going to take us to another memory cutscene. That will transfer us to the next area. So let's just see before we do that if there's anything secret over here. Is it secret? Is it safe? It's not secret. and appears to be relatively safe. Okay, let's go through here.
Dinah saved my life. I survived because she showed me how to escape. I didn't leave the lamp in the library, and Dinah didn't knock it over. The lamp and Dinah were upstairs when I went to bed. Dinah was in the room with me when the fire started.
Another key of insight, and she now seems to be somewhat convinced that she didn't kill her family, which is nice. Or rather, start the fire that killed her family. Okay, so I feel like this is going to be a pretty good place to end this episode. We'll probably be able to get through the rest of this chapter in the next one. Thank you very much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do drop me a like, leave me a comment, subscribe for more content like this, and I'll see you next time for more Alice Madness Returns. Take care, guys, and goodbye.